Hello everyone, I'm Yanni from BU4U Gaming, and today we are back in Potion Pause, and I am closing in on level 5. I think I only needed to make like 6 or 7 more of these, so it might be 3 or 4 more, and then we should hit level 5, which means we can get into taming. Ooh, yes, look at that, unlocked a taming potion blueprint. Okay, so I think I'm gonna stop right here. I do actually have more, but I don't know if there's a reason to level up more. Well, there might be more levels coming later, right? But I think for right now, I'm just gonna stop right here, and then we are gonna go and check out the board down there. What am I looking for? I am looking for this. I finally got another quest from the quest board instead of constantly just one for one of these grow plant potions. I finally got one for green palladium, or caladium. So that is what we're gonna do, and I think we're just gonna sell these ones. There we go, so that should give us a little bit more money, and then we are gonna head straight over here. Ooh, and that's a quest for us. Yep. So let's go and check it out. This is gonna be exciting. Let's just have a little quick look at this first. Yeah, okay, so it says 2000 for the next one, but it isn't really a next one. So I don't know, maybe I'll still level it up some more. I do want to make more money, so I might just do it anyway. And then hopefully it works retroactively later on if they add more levels. But let's focus on this for right now. As a thank you from the Adventurers Guild for cleansing the Earth Zone to reach a level 5 cleanse, here's a reward. We're halfway to cleansing the Zone of Corruption. There's a new potion for you to create, the Taming Potion. Don't forget to claim your reward in the book. Aha! Okay, so let's do that. It looked like we already got it, but let's just do it the intended way. So upgrade Taming Potion unlocked. There we go. I don't know much about it, but the taming potion you've just discovered is meant to calm the corrupted creatures in these parts. Stories say with it, the creatures will show their loyalty and follow you around. I hear Conrad is very interested in the creatures in these parts. Yeah, so we can probably sell some to him if we want to. Let's deliver this. Nice. And it always takes a little while before that quest disappears. Okay, nothing new from Sid, it doesn't look like, or from Birdie, but oh, we're gonna be able to tame something, guys. Oh, but it looks like Conrad has a quest. He probably has a specific request for one, but otherwise we should be able to just sell them in here like we can with the potions. I just heard you are able to tame creatures in these parts now. If you come across any that you'd like to sell, I'll make sure they go to good homes. Ew. Yep. Okay. So let's go up and see what we actually need for these potions, because it's going to be a question if we actually have what we need for it, right? So let's see. Oh, look at this. So one potion bottle, 10 firefly and 10 moon glow flower. Oh, then it's a good thing that I have not been using up all my fireflies. I did that in the beginning to kind of make some money out of them, but this is going to be much better. Let's just put you in there, and then we actually have enough for 8. I'm not sure I have that many Moonglow flowers. I have been collecting some of them, but yes, we have 50 in here. And 4 there, but at least 50, that is a beginning, right? Okay, I didn't actually click on it. Say select. And then we are gonna see how this is gonna work. Oh, I love the look of it. It looks so cool. Okay, so we are just gonna make... I wonder if this gives us XP, actually. Because it is part of the Earth Zone tree, right? Or like a level tree, so... I don't know. Here we go. So that was the 5 we can make right now. Let's put the rest of the fireflies in here. And... yep. My inventory is kind of full. I'm gonna have to make a whole bunch of potions later to kind of get rid of all this stuff, as you can see. But that should also give me some more levels. Okay, so we're gonna go and see if we can find something to test this out on, and then I assume we just have to throw it at a creature. But I guess we'll find out. And but I just wanted to see. Okay, no, 5 XP. I didn't even notice if it said 0 or 5 before, but if it was, then we'd only gotten 1 for each of these, so that would not really be worth it, right? Not compared to getting 15 XP from the clean dirt potions, which is a lot easier to collect resources from. Okay, so let's see, we have this pretty little green one. Let's see what we have around. They do new ones respawn every time you load the game. It seems so. There's always different ones. Usually there's mice over here, but not today. And sometimes there's a lot of them, and sometimes there's only a few. Right now there's only one, so I might have to end up reloading. But I think we're just gonna tame that one. Of course, I would want one of every color myself, and then Conrad would just have to wait. Potentially, we'll see if we get a quest when we tame one. Okay, so I'm not seeing any other ones right now, so I think we're just going to try and see if we can tame this one over here and see how this works. There we go. So if I do this... Ooh, looky looky. Oh, I don't know what that means. Oh. Oh, I had to remember the order. Oh no, I didn't do that. I don't know. I think it started with a red one. And maybe there was a green one. I'm still gonna mess up, but okay, I didn't know that this was gonna happen. See, I messed up. Okay, so what is that? Green, blue, blue, green, or is that a yellow? Okay, it's a green. Green, green, oh, I pressed the same one again. Why did that not work? Didn't it say green, green, blue, yellow, or green, green, blue, green? Oh, I'm confused. I'm so gonna mess up with this. Why did it use 2 of my potions, actually? It says I only have 3 back left. Didn't we make 5 of them? And I don't remember it telling me to throw one again. It just gave me the option to try it again. Okay, well, we're going to try again. And then I'm going to have to try and pay attention. Oh, short-term memory. That is not good. Okay, green. Well, yellow. 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 Right? So this one. And T. 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 Oh, yay! We got one! Oh, there you are! Hey, look at you! Aw! So what can I do with it? Can I pick you up? It doesn't seem like I can pick you up. It looks like you might be... Yeah, you're gonna follow me, but how do I, like, put you somewhere? Because we would want to tame some more of them, right? And how am I supposed to give one to Conrad if... we can't pick them up. So there's no like E or F or anything. If I press E or F or something, no, that doesn't do anything. So how do I actually do that? And I don't see you in my inventory or anything. Okay, let's try and talk to you. It's such a thrill when the waves crash over the bow. Oh yeah, when you're out sailing. No, Max, I don't have time right now. Now I have a little whiny kitty in the background. Hvad er det? Jamen, jeg har ikke tid, måske. Okay, will you follow me in here? No. Okay, come on. Can I get you inside? No. Okay. Because there is this. Haha. Yeah, okay, so we got a flower fly, because I remembered we saw this in here, right? And that's how it would work in Garden Paws, actually. But in Garden Paws, you have access to it, like, on you. You can see your character and what you're wearing is kind of out here on the side, and then you have, like, a pet slot. So I figured if we just went in here, and then if I do this... See? Nice. So in this one, at least so far, you can actually interact directly with them, but... you can do it that way. Oh, that is so cool, guys. That is so cool. Okay, so now we have one. I kind of want to keep it, but let's just go and see how much it actually is if we're going to try and sell it. Otherwise, I'm sure a new one is going to spawn at some point. So let's just try and... Oh. Nope, it won't let me do it. Okay, so I guess you can't do that currently. But there was actually a post on the Kickstarter page for the game because it was originally on Kickstarter. And if anyone is curious about what the plans are for the game kind of in the future or what the developers are focusing on right now, I recommend reading the last update. Just go on Kickstarter and search for Potion Pause. I might also just add the link in the description below because it does seem like they update that. So, but in that one they did say that you can actually sell these creatures, so it's definitely intended, and which we could also see based on this on the quest text, right? But I think we're just gonna put you in there. It's kind of funny that it changes color. Sometimes it kind of looked like it turned purple. Well, I have two more. So I think we're gonna try to tame another one, but before we do that, or we might do it next time because then probably some new ones have spawned in, but otherwise I could just, you know, save and close the game and load it up again, because I do want to try and tame some more, but at least now we know how it works, right? You just have to have a reasonable short-term memory. Mine is usually terrible and I'm actually sick at the moment, so that doesn't help with focusing, but I just had to play some more because I knew we were getting so close to taming. But anyway, I want to open a new area and I have enough money that we can do it. And Irene left a comment saying that the orbs, apparently it's a flower, should spawn in the, or that I should be able to get those when I go down the stairs and the first area on the right. So I assume that's this one over here, right? Either way, we're gonna open the other ones as well, but I think that's what we're gonna try and do. Unlocked Earth Orb Potion Blueprint. Oh, nice. Thank you for that tip, Irene. Oh yeah, nice. Okay, so we're gonna grab some of these. And then we're gonna go home and try and make that. Maybe we'll try and wait. How many did I get? We got 14. I suspect that might be enough for a potion. Usually they don't take any more than 10 of something. But of course the reason I wanted that was because I was messing around with this place last time. Unsuccessfully, I may add. I don't know how long it's gonna take. Sometimes they respawn pretty fast. You know what we can do? Let's just go over here and grab a few more Moon Glow flowers. In case you guys don't remember which ones these are, that is these ones. It's also the ones you get if you use the Grow Plant Potion. Or I don't know if you can get different ones from the Grow Plant Potion, but these are the ones I have gotten from that. But so far, this is the only place I can get them otherwise. But eventually, I'm sure there's other areas that are going to have some of them. Okay, well, we got a few more. Let's just quickly see if... Let's grab you. Again, not that we have any use for the harvester flowers yet, but we will later, I'm sure. Here we go. They are already respawned, so let's just grab some more. So we're sure we have enough to make another potion, right? Yep, let's do that, and then we're gonna head back home. And then we can quickly see if anything has respawned. I think I have to reload or maybe leave the zone and come back for something new to spawn. Though maybe they will start spawning the longer you play. That might be a thing as well. But I've noticed there's a big difference because sometimes I've had like 5 creatures out here at once. And sometimes there's only one. I'm not really seeing anymore. No. I really want one of the purple mice. They're so cute. Well, I want all the colors of mice, of course. And all the colors of these, like, what were they called? What were they called? Where did I put you? I put you in a storage somewhere. Not in here. Okay, let's put you away, you away, you. Okay, you have 28. What was it called? Oh, I've forgotten. A flower fly, that's what it's called. They kind of look a little bit like a butterfly. Oh, we got more than one. Look at that. We have this one. So now we have a place for Sinia. There's this one, so now we have another use for something with pumpkins and orb plants. Yellow, I think it says yellow orb potion. And blue orb potion, so for that we would need the blue caladium and the orb plant. And then we have the earth orb potion. So that will be the green one. It's interesting they've called this one an earth one, and this is not called a water one. I would have thought this was a water one, and the yellow one would be the fire one. And then we have, I think it's purple, purple orb potion. What would the purple color be when it comes to like elements? Air maybe? Would they have made the purple one air? I don't know. Anyway, we need this. It's a good thing I actually have some green caladium that I've been collecting instead of just selling off those. They should be out here. Let's grab some of these. And I think we just probably just need one, right? Let's see. Earth or potion? Yes. Select. And then we're going to make one of these potions. Lovely. And that sells for 670. I would say it's not really worth it to sell it because the green, at least not at this stage, because the green caladium, so far I've only seen, I think, two spawns of it. Maybe there's three in the earth zone. So it's pretty slow to actually collect these. I've just been doing it every time when I was collecting this. I don't think I want to make any more of these right now. I'm just going to have to make sure I actually hit it when we get over to that those green rocks. But Squeaking Lion left a comment as well, suggesting that we could use, I'm just going to do this for fun, guys, that we could use the explosive potion over there just to see if we can light it. So we need pink caladium and blue caladium. Okay. Then we're going to grab a few of these, and we're going to grab a few of these. Man, I'm going to run out of space. I always forget to click on this. There we go. So let's just try that first. I don't know. I think we need to use the orb one. That would make sense because that's what it actually said that we should. I just didn't know whether or not there were any orb potions in the game yet when we were trying to mess with it in the last video. Let's put you away, and then we have a taming potion. How many do I have of these now? I have 10. Ooh, we can make another taming potion. What was it we needed for these? Moonglow flowers and, like I said, short-term memory is terrible. Here we go, firefly. Yes. And always forget this. And yes, I know we can make the other orb potions, but I think I'm gonna wait because I'm kind of running out of storage space at the moment. And I don't have any need for them right now. Because I haven't seen any other places where we would need those. So for now I'm just gonna leave that. And yep, there we go. Yep. And then we're gonna make them later. We are definitely gonna make them later. Always grab another bottle. Okay, so here we go. Let's head back over there. And then, of course, next time we're gonna mess with taming some more animals. In this video, I just kind of wanted to try it out, figure out how it actually works. And then we're gonna start collecting more so we can get a full collection of these. Ooh, it's so exciting, guys. I love that we got into taming now. And from what I understand, the next thing the developers are going to be working on is the water zone. And they have apparently also said on their live stream, which I hadn't watched, but someone mentioned it in the Discord, I think it was, that they have said they also want to start working on cooking fairly soon, because that way we can get some cooking recipes, and then we'll have something extra to sell next to all these potions, right? Okay, so let's just try this. I think I have to be fairly close. So something like this. Nope, didn't do anything. I didn't think it would, but there we go. Okay, so now we're gonna try this. Oh, looky, so pretty. Okay. So now we have lit it. But I don't know if it's supposed to do anything else. Like, I can't interact with it. I can walk up into this. That is definitely a good idea. Go up here and get ourselves burned. Later on, if we actually get like a health bar, because it doesn't seem like we have one currently, that might actually hurt. But it does look pretty. I do like that. Very nice. It would be cool if it had some kind of effect other than that. Like it would trigger, you know, the spawn of something new or something, but I don't know if it does. Okay, but that was cool. That was cool. We sorted one of these. Now we still have to figure out what we could do with the egg over here. Any ideas for that, guys? The only idea I had was the firefly, but we can't actually throw that at it. Of course, I could just make one of every potion that we can actually use and try and throw them at it and see if it does anything. That could be an option. But right off the bat, I don't really have a clue other than the fireflies as to what we would want to do there. Okay, but I think that is it for today, guys. We are gonna do some more taming next time and potentially open up another area or two. And then hopefully we'll see some new updates coming soon from the developers. I'm so excited, guys. I really, really love the look of the game and I love the direction it's going in. I know a few people have said that they wish that it would have been a DLC for Garden Paws instead of a separate game, but I actually like that it's a game in its own right and that it's going in a different direction, even if some things, like the characters, look similar and there is some similarities in the graphics. Like they do look similar, but at the same time the scenery is very different. But so far I'm actually a big fan of it being its own game and in its own right, right? Anyway, let me know what you think of things so far. We have pretty much covered the majority of the content. I only have a few areas left to open. And of course we can tame some more creatures, but other than that, I've covered pretty much all of it so far. So yeah, that is it for today. Thank you for watching, and as always, do take care and happy gaming!